So we make it sometimes too easy for the enemy to get us off track because we fall into a category or we fall into an area of complaining, of beating ourselves up, of saying that, you know, life wouldn't be like this if I didn't make that decision. One thing about it, every decision that we've made cannot be reversed. It's like words that go out of your mouth. You can say I'm sorry all you want to, but once they have gone out of your mouth, they do good or damage. And a lot of times people say things when they get in heated arguments and heated discussions, and they didn't mean to say it. It came out, and they may later say I'm sorry or I apologize, but once the word has gone out, it has done the damage. And you know, when people are damaged, they are sorry, just can't undamage you that fast. Sometimes it takes time to get your heart back right. Sometimes it takes time for you to regain confidence in an individual. So the devil can easily get us off track, but we can't make it too easy for him. We have to do our due diligence and make sure that we have our I's and T's crossed. Satan is the master of distractions. God has placed you and I on a road that he has designed for us to travel. But the enemy does everything he can to take us off of that road and put us on a detour. And we've got to be very careful that we don't allow the failures and the mistakes of the past to cause us to go on a detour. I've seen detours in my lifetime, and all of us have had to travel down some roads and seen some detour signs, but I found out that sometimes the detour signs can take you out of the way. Sometimes a detour sign can get you lost. And sometimes, I don't know if the folks that were putting up the signs got tired. They put up the signs detour, but down the road you never did see where they said continue. You know, you can get lost sometimes going on a detour. And so we've got to be very careful because the devil wants us to get lost. He's not there to help us to be what God wants us to be. He wants us to get lost. He doesn't want us to find our way. He does not want you and I to make headway and to travel in the right direction. He wants you to lose everything. He comes to steal, kill, and destroy. He wants you to lose hope. He wants you to lose joy. He wants you to lose enthusiasm. He wants you to lose stamina and endurance. The devil wants you to lose everything, but God is a keeper. He wants you to keep the good stuff. He's come to give you life and life more abundantly. And if you get lost, Jesus can find you. Hallelujah. The disciples encountered a distraction that was designed to alter their faith. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, distractions come for two reasons. Number one, to get you off course. And number two, to challenge your faith. And that's why distractions come. They come either to get you off course or to alter or challenge your faith. Because I don't know how it happens, but Satan has a way. God still allowed him to be in the realm, in the heavenly realm, where he can kind of hear some things, because the Bible says in Job, when the sons of God came to present themselves before the Lord, Satan came also among them. So now we are the sons of God. It doesn't eliminate women. Sons of God mean the children of God. So as the children of God, as men and women of God, we have come to present ourselves today before the Lord. But the Bible said Satan came also among them. So he's got a way of sneaking in. Got a way of coming in and mixing in with us. That's why it's hard now to tell a saint from a sinner. Because people have a way of mixing in. They dress like you dress. They shout like you dress. They'll shout like you shout. Some people shout and haven't seen God, haven't heard God, don't know if God exists, but still shout. They have a way of mixing in the crowd. Satan comes also among them. And so now you can't be the judge and I can't be the judge, and we like to throw that, don't judge nobody, but the Lord say, I can judge you by your fruit. We do know folks by their fruit. And when your fruit is good, you just won't do certain things. But when your fruit is rotten to the core, you might say anything. You might cuss somebody out. You might, oh my God, try to kill somebody if your fruit's not good. But when your fruit is good, you love folks. Even in spite of folks, you still love them if you got good fruit. When your fruit is good, you look in the mirror and say, I'm not perfect and neither are they. When your fruit is good, you can go on in life. Regardless to what comes and what is against you, you can still go on. But Satan has designed to distract us. I don't believe you can even be a good saint. I don't believe you can be a good follower of Christ until you've had some distractions, till you've had some challenges, till you've had some issues that you've had to encounter. You can't be a good saint. The Lord would allow them to face a test like they've never had before. He would have them to face an ultimate test. And how many of you know, no test, no testimony? In order for you to have a testimony, you've got to have a test. Tell your neighbor, no test, no testimony. See, we need some tests so we can have some testimonies. Oh, we've got to have some tests. Jesus said, or not Jesus, John the Revelator in Revelations said that they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the words of their testimony. That means that a testimony is good at all times. You ought to keep a testimony in your spirit. And you don't have to wait until service time to have testimony, because some people are only professional testifiers. But you don't have to wait until a service calls a testimony service. You are sitting next to somebody right now and you can share a testimony with them. If you don't say nothing else but the Lord's been good to me, that's a testimony. If you say that the Lord kept me, that's a testimony. You don't need to have somebody put a microphone in front of your face to testify. You don't need to say service starts at 7 o'clock and we're going to have testimony from 7 o'clock to 7:25 to testify. You ought to have a testimony at all times. And so it's good to have a testimony. John said they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. Yes. Oh my God, look how he hooks it up with the same things. Oh my God, that Paul said in Romans, you can be saved by believing, but your salvation incomplete until you say something out of your mouth, till you confess it with your mouth. And John said the same thing. Yes, the blood of the Lamb can deliver you, but you overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of your testimony. You got to say something. Look at your neighbor and say, you got to say something. You got to tell somebody how good God is and how good God has been to you. You got to open your mouth and say something sometime that God is really good. And you know what else? You got to say something other than in church. Because in church it's easy to say something in here. Oh, we can all say something in here. But do you still have the same zeal, the same fire, the same enthusiasm when you get among unsaved relatives? Do you want them to know that you got the joy of the Lord when you get on your job?